Hello everyone and welcome back to another video of the Scrapy tutorial series. So in the last video, all we did was we installed our Scrapy and we created a project so that we can continue further, and it was a pretty short video, about 7 minutes or 8 minutes long. So if you haven't watched it, go right now and watch it because that's really crucial to follow this one, because that's where you get all of these files. So let's continue with our Scrapy tutorial, and we will actually do some coding today and save some data to our project. Okay, so before starting, I just want to say that I'm recording this tutorial fourth or fifth time. I can't even remember, because actually my PC is messing with me, and every time I record, I hear pretty bad background noise, or my PC is not just recording any sound. So okay, so let's go ahead with our tutorial. Okay, so before coding anything, I just want to show you the website that we are going to be scraping. So this is actually a website made by Scrapy itself to practice web scraping, and it is actually a very straightforward and simple website. It has some codes that we can scrape with some authors and some tags, so it does not place any restrictions or web scraping or anything, so that we can scrape it straightforwardly. So let's go ahead and scrape it. So before scraping, one last thing, and that is I just wanna tell you about this project structure and how this Scrapy works. So in here we have our project file Scrapy that we made, and then in here we have our Scrapy project file, which is called tutorial scraper, and that's what we named our Scrapy project, right? So in here we have another folder named tutorial scraper, and then we have a file called scrapy.cfg. So it is not a very interesting file, so we can open it, and you can see we have just two settings right over here, and we have a link to the documentation from where you can know more. And this will actually be useful when we deploy our scrapers to the cloud platform or things like that. Isn't very required at this time. So in here we have our main project, and that's where we get our main files that we're interested in. Okay, right, so you won't have this file right over here, so let me delete it. I just created it dynamically. Okay, so you can see that we have our files in here, and we have the tutorial scraper file, and in here we have the spiders file folder, and then we have some Python files, which I'll explain in a bit. So you can see that we have our spiders folder. When we open it, we have a file called init.py. So what this spiders folder will do, that this spiders folder will contain all our spiders in a form of Python object in different files, or maybe we can even put it in a single file, since they are all Python objects and nothing very special. So let me close it, and you can see that we have some more files in here that are very interesting. So let me start with this settings.py file. So this settings.py file actually contains all the main settings for our project that we will be setting up but messing up with to change things in our project and make them work. So you can see that we have some setting encoding which is commented out, we have some documentation links, and then you can see that we have the bot name. So what do we mean by a bot in here, and why is this the bot name? So you can see that the bot name is set to tutorial scraper, which is essentially the name of our project. So what do we mean by a bot? This whole project is actually a bot, and these spiders are actually the scripts which give us the data, and all of these scripts together schedule the spiders, get the data, and do something with the data. That's why they are called bots. They are like automation scripts, right? So that's why they are called bots. This whole project is a bot, and these spiders are a part of it. So it is set to tutorial scraper. You could change it, but I'm not going to do that. And after that, we have some not so interesting settings. We have the user agent, and you might know what that is. And after that, we have a very interesting setting, robots.txt_obey. So what does this do? So as I told you in my earlier tutorial videos of the Scrapy series, what is robots.txt? So robots.txt is actually a file which contains all the rules that a web scraper must follow to scrape that website, and every website has robots.txt. Most of them do and some do not, but hey, consider that all of them have it. Almost all of them have it, right? So we have the robots.txt_obey. So what this does is that it specifies whether you want to obey the robots.txt file rules or not. So it is set to true, which means that it will obey the rules and will not scrape those web pages which are not allowed to scrape. And if we set it to false, we can also scrape the web pages which are not allowed to crawl by that website. So you know that, but I'm not going to change it. We might change it later when we go to proxies and stuff, but that's for later. And we have the concurrent requests, and these are actually the limits that we can set on our bots, that in a second how much requests we can make and how much requests we can make in a day or so, because we don't want to be detected that we are a web scraper by the website. And actually the another reason is that if we spawn a lot of requests to the website might go down, and we don't want that, right? And they may actually detect that you are a bot and may ban you or ban your IP address. So you don't want that. Then we have some more interesting settings which we'll be messing up with later, and we have some more limits in here, auto throttle, which will just slow down our bot to simulate human behavior and etc. stuff. So we won't actually talk about this much. So now you know what settings.py file is, and hopefully you got it. Tell me in the comments below if you still have a doubt about this. It has already been 7 minutes. So we have some more files in here, and actually one more thing before we start coding, and that is if you don't know this whole thing is actually a package, if I'm not wrong. If you don't know, a package in Python is essentially like a library, but it is a bit different from that, because all of the objects and stuff is organized in its different files. And this init.py file is almost in every package. And what this does is that this just gets together all your components and assembles them. So for example, you have some objects lying over there, some lying over there, so it will get them together and start the project. I know you didn't get that, but don't worry, I will link in the description, and it is not very relevant to the topic of this video. So let's continue further. And I hope I told you that what this spiders file does. So let's now go into the coding stuff and do some coding. So we will be doing our coding in this init.py file. So you have to open it up, and I will explain you later about what this items.py, middlewares and pipelines files do when we will get to that stuff later. So remember I told you that spiders are essentially some Python objects that we have to initialize. So first we have to import Scrapy. So we have to import Scrapy, and then we have to create our Python object. So class, and then let's call our object tutorial scraper, tutorial spider. Okay, and then we have to inherit from Scrapy dot spider. And if you don't know about what is inheritance, then I encourage you to go on and study something about it. Okay, so let's go ahead. And so now we have to give our spider a name. So I'm going to give it a name of tutorial_spider. And then after that, we have to define some URLs. So we'll say start URLs, and this will contain our start URL. So right now we only have to crawl one website, so we will copy this URL, right? And then what we will do is that we will paste it right over here. And remember, these variable names are explicit and you don't want to change them, because that is why Scrapy references them to be and gets them and creates your spider. So you want them to be like that, so don't forget to spell them correctly or you will be in trouble. So after that, we have to define a method called parse, and this is explicit as well. Self and then comma, and we have to get a parameter called response. And this response parameter is actually our response to the request we sent to this website. and this will contain our response code, if it was successful or not, and our HTML data and stuff. So after that we need to say, so what do we get to scrape from it now? So let us scrape all the codes first, then we will see about the authors and the tags. So let us open the console, and remember what I told you, we have to reference these elements by the name of their elements or their classes or IDs. For this you must have some basic understanding of HTML. So let's go ahead, and you can see that when I select this element, right, we have an element of span. It is actually an element of span with a class of text, right? You can see that right over here. So what we can do is that we can reference it by using a CSS selector. So we can say quotes, and this will actually be an array of quotes. So quotes equals response dot CSS. This CSS method is actually for CSS selectors, and then in here we had span and then a class of dot txt, because remember we had the element span with a class of text, and a class is denoted in CSS by dot, right? And then we don't want the HTML data, we just want the text, right? So we can say colon colon text to get the text, and then after that we have to extract the text because this will still give us some HTML. So we'll extract it, and then we will have to yield it so that we can see it on the screen. So you will get what I'm saying about in a second, so don't worry. So after that, so we have to pass a dictionary, so quotes then colon and then quotes, and this yield keyword is actually used in a generator, and this actually is a generator behind the scenes in Scrapy. And so I won't go too much into what generator is because that is not very relevant to the topic, as I earlier said that this package was not very relevant. So let me save it, and after that, as we are done with our spider, right? Now we have to go into the terminal. So go into the terminal, let me clear the screen real quick. Okay, so now it is clean. Okay, so we have to go into the terminal, and you can see that we are in the folder called scrapy.dot in the parent directory. So from there we have to go into all the way into this working directory that we're working in. Okay, so we have to say cd tutorial scraper. So we are in this directory right over here, so we have to get into this directory. So we'll do it once again, cd scraper, then we will have to clear the screen. Okay, so to use this spider, what we need to do is we have to call scrapy crawl, and then the name of our spider, which is tutorial spider, right? So we'll say tutorial spider. Okay, so after we execute it, you can see that we get a bunch of stuff in here, and when we scroll up in here somewhere in between, you can see that we have the codes in a dictionary, and we have the codes in the array right after that. We have the codes, the first code, and then we have the second code, and we have all the codes right over there. Now we got the codes successfully, but how do I get the authors and the tags? So we can do something similar. We select the authors. You can see that we have Albert Einstein right over here, right? So after I select it, you can see that we have an element of small with a class of author, so we can use this to get this author for each and every quote. So after I go in here, let me get the authors. So right, authors equals, and then we will do response.css, quite similar, right? And then in here we have to say small dot author, and then we have to extract it because it was an element of small with a class of author, and we need to get the text. I almost forgot that. And then in here we have to yield it at last, or otherwise we won't know what we got from that. So authors, and then yield, and then authors. Now when we execute this in the terminal, let me clear the screen real quick, and then when I execute the command again, scrapy crawl tutorial spider, we get a bunch of stuff once again. And okay, so I actually misspelled it. Okay, so now it's good, and we have to execute it once again. So when we execute it, you can see that we have the quotes and the authors in their specific arrays. So let's do something similar for the tags as well. So go in here, and then we get the tags, and you can see that we have an element of A with a class of tag for all the tags. So we can get the tags for all the quotes like this. So let's go in here and say tags equals response.css. Okay, so that's a comma right over here, .css, and then we had a.tag, and then we need to get the text, or otherwise we will be playing with the HTML. Then the extract, so we'll extract the text out of it, and then at last we have to yield it, or we won't see it. So tags, and then yield the tags. This will be an array as well. So after we run it, you can see that we get a bunch of stuff again, and we have the quotes, okay, and then we have the authors, and then we have the tags. So it is showing up in the terminal, right? So now you ask me, okay, so we can see that, but how do I store it in a file so that I can use it as data? How do I do it? So we can do that from the terminal as well. So let me clear the terminal. So we can just say scrapy crawl, and then the name of our spider, which is tutorial spider. Okay, tutorial spider, and then we have to give it an argument dash o, and then the name of our output files, and this dash o stands for the output. So let us say quotes.json, right? So after I run it, you can see that we got the output again, and this time if I do this and reload it, we can see that we have a file called quotes.json, and when we open it, we have the code stored in here, then we have the authors, and then at last we must have the tags. Okay, yeah, so here we get the tags, right? This is how we can store it in a file, and I'm seeing over here that it has been a little over 20 minutes, so I'll just close this right over here, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next tutorial.